laughing stock right now in the world when it comes to security. And of course, the coconut meme. And I'm interested to find out how her performance as a prosecutor will translate into her campaign. We need someone who can go toe-to-toe with Trump on the podium. Too bad Trump back out for the last minute. And as a moderate voter, I'm actually entertained by this week's turns of events. Welcome back, and you're still here watching Viewpoint. So, magre-react lang ako sa latest hula-balo dito sa US election. Ano po? It's a very exciting week for the US politics. The drama and suspense and the twist. The twist, yeah. You never see them coming. Last week, habang nagde-telecast namin yung latest news segment, may breaking news na binaril daw si Trump. And so yun nga, apparently, nakasurvive si Donald. Unsurprisingly. And buong linggo, ito ang laman ng mga headlines. Iba't ibang speculations, expectation, conspiracy theories ang naglalabasan kung sino ang mastermind sa assassination attempt. At syempre, kasama na dyan ang both Republicans and Democrats accusing and blaming each other about the cause of the incident. What a surprise, ha? Republicans accusing the liberals na matagal na din lang gustong ipatumba itong si Hyper Trump. Democrats naman accusing the MAGA na stage o peke lang daw yung assassination. At syempre, naiipit dito yung Secret Service na base sa kanilang official statement so far ay talagang they definitely dropped the bomb big time on this one. Saan ka nakakita ng 20 years old, inexperienced, unskilled assassin na na-outsmart ang Secret Service at mga otoridad? First time happening in America, di ba? I must admit, there's a lot of odd things going on before the assassination. It looks very, very, I should say, suspicious. And I'm afraid we will never gonna find out the truth of what really happened. Other than the fact that an innocent person died and they forget about it right away and lots of people are injured. We're a laughing stock right now in the world when it comes to security. Yeah, exactly. It's really laughable. Diba? Ang consolation dito, yung Secret Service Director resigned after 2 weeks of excuses. The bad thing is, nobody fired her before that resignation happens. Because she should have been fired already right on the very next day of the assassination attempt. Now, she's slapping her way out with her well-earned pension. Bottom line, we can't deny na super favorable ito dito kay re-electionist convicted felon. Lahat siyang pinag-uusapan sa buong linggo and definitely boost his popularity. Ayon sa mga polls, mas lalong naging solid ang suporta dito kay Trump. Kapaligtara naman ito sa mga Democrats. Na as usual, laging watak-watak at lalong dumami ang nagko-call out kay Biden na mag-drop out sa election. Maraming nagsasabi na he's not fit anymore in spite ng maraming sinabi nitong presidente na di daw siya bibitaw at kaya niya pa. Daw. And then the unexpected happened. Yan sinasabi kong twist. Biden called their bluff and decided to quit on the race. What a twist. Biglang na-scramble itong Republicans. Di nila ina-expect na tututuhanin ni Biden ang pag-resign. But as usual, they bashed the president after the announcement, same as how they bashed him before. If he stays in the race, he's too old. If he quits, he's a coward. You can't really win with these Republicans. Nevertheless, solid pa rin ang kanilang kampo pagdating sa suporta kay Trump. Not so much with Democrats on the first 12 hours. As usual, mga liberals, they want everything and everyone wants something. They want their cake and eat it too. Ngayon, nag-quit na sa race itong si Biden, imbis na maging solid at supportan kung sino magiging kapalit na partida. Abay, parang katulad ng panahon ni Hillary ang kaisipan ng mga netizens. Mababasa mo mga message nila. Eh, Keso ayaw din na kay Harris kasi in-endorse, kahit in-endorse na ito ni Biden, kasi hindi naman daw kilala itong si Kamala. Palagi daw siyang wala sa limelight. What are you talking about? Where have you been the past 4 years? You voted for Biden, which means you voted for Kamala. What kind of a voter are you? Diba? Also, that's the job of the vice president, is to be out of the limelight so that the president get all the credit or blame. And it's your job as a voter to be informed, to find out about the candidate background, her skills, her policy, her platform. It's your job. So mas gusto nyo matulad sa panahon ni Hillary na yung iba ayaw bumoto. And look what happened. You end up with Trump. And then you're whining. So I did a quick digging about Kamala and learned about her past accomplishments and of course the coconut meme. And I'm interested to find out how her performance as a prosecutor will translate into her campaign. And then another twist happened. Within 24 hours, Kamala gained more than 100 million fans, mostly from grassroots supporters. Never, it's unprecedented. What a record. And she started her campaign at Milwaukee, and boy, she breathed a new life in the Democrat campaign. That, we must admit, it's on a life support during Biden. I can't wait for her debate with Trump. This is gonna be interesting matchup. We need someone who can go toe-to-toe with Trump on the podium. Too bad Trump back out for the last minute. And as a moderate voter, I'm actually entertained by this week's turns of events. We will find out how legit Kamala is, yes, and wanna hear more about her policy, because we already know what we expect about Trump. But Kamala, she has probably a lot of ace on her sleeves. And to all Democrats, I say, get your shit together and rally behind your candidate. Otherwise, stop whining if you end up with another 4 years with Trump. Or if you're lucky, if you still have a democracy by then. But so far, it's a very simple choice. Americans are voting for dictatorship or woke democracy. Putting kids in cages or uncontrolled open border. Simple choice. Project 2025 or Me Too Wokeness Liberalism. The prosecutor or the perpetrator. Or most people say, felon. It is on. We'll be back para sa mga reaction ko naman sa katatapos lang na SONA ni PBBM right after the break.